by Chairman Mr. Sunil Mantri, by President Mr. Praveen Jain, my dearest friend Ashok Patni, the man who has kind of harassed me the most, Rajan Bandelkar. So many of my illustrious seniors who are here. Tara, who certainly embarrassed me today. All our dear friends from the industry, from the media, ladies and gentlemen. It's a very, very funny turn of my life. And I think the fault is my granddaughter. I have a 3.5-year-old granddaughter. And because of her, on Sunday mornings, I go to a play area where I have to crawl, go on slides, jump on trampolines, play with balls. I swim in balls, plastic balls, and play the fool with her for 1.5 hours every Sunday. Somehow or the other, I feel young again. And I think it's probably the fault of my granddaughter that I have tried to come back at a young age of 65 to come back into public arena after 14 years when I was president of MCHI and also director of NATCO and and was part of the formation of NARELCO when I was advisor to the government of India and we created the first national housing policy. So I think it's kind of re-coming back and becoming younger in that sense of the term, and it's quite a lot of fun to really come back together. But I have to be grateful to each and every one of you for giving me that kind of love, affection, kindness and joy at being here and coming in so many numbers. I thought you'd find difficulty to get 10 people to come for such a ceremony because I remember it was thing and I never expected, and of course our national president Patni Saab to come all the way from their home place in order to actually give us this honor of being over here together. Sunil has told me that he wants a mandate. He's the boss now. He used to be my secretary, now he's my boss. Sunil, I don't think we should really look at it in such a small way. I think what we need to do is to look at what the Prime Minister wants. The Prime Minister wants, and we want to demand from the Prime Minister and the government. But you can't demand till you don't give. I think NARELCO, if permitted, should learn to do something for the government or the Prime Minister or the state, and we should start today. If I have your permission, I want NARELCO West to sit down and make 200,000 houses on a cost-to-cost basis, so there is no profit whatsoever, to create an SPV to build in Mumbai 200,000 houses for the government, wherever they have land, whether it is salt pan lands or others. And we have only one or two conditions which we will put to them. The first condition is that we certainly want the ease of doing business. That is mandated by the Prime Minister, but it has not happened on the ground. So we will request and demand, not because we want it for our industry, but because we need to meet the objectives of the Prime Minister. We need to say very clearly that we don't want the time taken, which is 2 to 3 years to get projects done, should be down to 2 to 3 months in order to create the affordable housing for all. And we shall put this as part of the mandate. I also think that the people who have sat here together, we should today commit another 100,000 houses in the affordable segment on the private sector land that we should do. So we should, out of the targets of 500,000 houses which the state government, NARELCO should commit that we will build free of cost, I mean cost-to-cost basis, 200,000 houses, and I cannot do it alone. I will need the help and cooperation of all you who are here. So before we complete it, I will request you to say, not that you have to do the work, but I need your support. I need your blessings and need your guidance. And we will do it is what I feel we should say today. Only when we commit this kind of thing that you can demand. You should demand whatever is necessary. There is a grossly unfair tax called service tax on houses. If I am a rich man and I can afford to wait for occupation certificate for my house, there is no service tax. If I am a poor man, I still pay service tax because I can't pay for it in one installment or after the building is ready. I think time has come that such unjust and unfair taxes have to be removed. And you don't have to request it, you have to demand it. So what you have to do is to commit to the government that their objective of what they want to achieve, we should be fully supportive. We are not an organization which is separate. We are a part of the government of India. We are a part of the aegis of creation of the government. You can read over here, it is under the Ministry of Housing and Urban and Poverty Development, and we have more than 5 or 6 joint secretaries of the government of India which participate in this thing. So it will be great joy for them that you will demand what we are asking. It is not going to be a request, because it is a fair thing to do. 14 years ago, when we were part of the new national housing policy at that time, Government of India introduced ATIB. ATIB was a tax-free for small housing because they realized that it could be done. Due to some problems and misuse of such provisions, this problem took up and ATIB had to be scrapped. I think it's time to say that we need to reintroduce such provisions. You can give tax-free for housing, because you can also give tax-free for exports. You can give tax-free for SEZ. You can give tax-free and portions and excessive depreciation and other things for IT. You give all the benefits that you need to do. Roti, kapra and makan, we do need that for housing also. So again, it's not a request. If you can make the small houses and we can make it into the segmentation that the government of India thinks is necessary to do, I think we need to see that these demands that we need to make, the similarly to the demand that Sunil Mantri makes of me, we should make of the government, but only after we stretch out and commit what we need to do. Strength of 500, I think you don't have to worry about it. 500 will come, 5,000 will come. The state of Maharashtra is much bigger than that. It's not numbers that count, but it will be the people who will deliver that. We have small numbers today in Naredko, but I can assure you that these small numbers will deliver what the government and policy wants. The development plan of Mumbai is the most horrible draft I have ever seen in my entire career and life. The 1991 draft that we did with the DC rules had lots of visionary ideas, including the idea of TDR, which was then copied by the entire country. It was a visionary document which really provided for the future. The latest development plan has no vision, no direction, no ambition, no aspiration, no feeling that my granddaughter 20 years hence will live in a city which is beautiful and wonderful. I will feel sad and may even ask my granddaughter not to continue to stay in this great city. A place where I have been brought up, I love and cherish. I think we need to ask the leaders of the city, and not ask, demand, that you need to change the vision document for the city, wherein such direction has to be given. I have to, of course, congratulate the Prime Minister. He has given us this vision. Where are the people in the housing sector in 65 years? We've never heard such a thing. This was the first time that we heard it. And we need to follow that battle cry of saying a housing revolution has to be created. And unless we don't follow the battle cry, such an aspiration will not be met. I don't see any issue in terms of meeting this whole thing. The stupidity of NOCs that you talked about, whether it was 72 or 32 or 52 or 102, is not relevant. It's the corruption. And I said, in some respects, I'm sorry, that my friend had to commit suicide. A dear friend of ours, person known to many of us here today. Let me tell you that the days of corruption are over after that. But now the days of extortion has started. People's demands are no more corrupt. They are extortion. And I think we need to see that the ease of doing business as committed by the Prime Minister, as committed by Mr. Venkaiah Naidu, as committed by Mr. Devendra Fadnavis, as committed by the two municipal commissioners who are wonderful people in Mumbai and Thane, both of whom I have personally met in this regard and have committed that they are going to make the paradigm change that is part of what we need to do. I also have to congratulate Mr. Fadnavis for the five major projects that he is pursuing. I, having come into this place, I have said it on TV several times, but today I think it's again an opportunity to say so. The five major projects will make the paradigm change for not the history of Mumbai, but the geography of Mumbai. He's looking at the change of Cross Harbour Bridge. He's looking at the metro, which will come over here. He's looking at the coastal road. He's looking at the Navi Mumbai Airport. He's looking about the Cross Harbour Bridge and the Pinjal River project, which will bring 24/7 water to Mumbai. A thing we have never thought of for the last 65 years. So congratulations, Mr. Chief Minister. Lots of those projects are already cleared by environmental clearances. Some of them are likely to take place very soon. Two of the major projects have already been agreed to be funded by JPEG, the Japanese promotion agency, for this debt funding that is there. I think these are the paradigms which we are seeing. So we are going to see this happening in Maharashtra. The leadership is there. Are we going to be able to carry out this leadership? Can we as industry not beg of anything anymore? We don't need to be beggars. But the public perception of the builders is extremely bad. And unless that public perception does not change by virtue of our stretching out to the people of Mumbai, by agreeing to make this participation happen, you will not be able to get cooperation either of the government, either of the Prime Minister, Chief Minister, the people, the judiciary, the activists. All of them are going to misuse authority in order to see that your work is not done. We will continue to cry, but we will not be able to achieve our objective. So it is my mission, Mr. President, Mr. Chairman, to say very simply that I would like your permission to commit on behalf of NALEDCO West that we will make these 200,000 houses for the government on any government land on a cost-to-cost basis. We will commit additionally small houses within, and we will give a list of those developers who will complete it in the next 5 years, another 100,000 houses, which will be on private land relating to these small areas. So we will tell the press, we will tell the government, we will tell India, we will tell the Prime Minister that in NALEDCO, we will start today committing to take care of housing for all, and we shall demand, not request, not plead, not do anything, that the paradigm necessary to create the environment of change does happen, will happen, and shall happen. Because I want that child of mine, the granddaughter of mine, to have a beautiful life in this great country and not think of thinking that a better life stays in onshore shores which are not part of this country. I do believe that you and I will win this war. This is the revolution that we must start today. So we must, from today, call it on behalf of NALEDCO again, permitted by my chairman and president, to call it the year of the housing revolution, called by NALEDCO and requested to the Prime Minister that the statement, housing of all, will be supported, not fully, but we shall take a lead to do these works, and if we will do it, we will succeed, because I do believe that we owe a duty to society. We have no choice if you want to die a death when people respect builders. And the only way you can derive this respect is if you give back to society what is needed, wanted. I promise you that the team which we have today, garnered in Nareko West, shall achieve these objectives. They are an extremely strong and wonderful team. They have the ambition, but we cannot just do it alone. We need the help of each and every one in the development industry. We need help from each and every one in the professionals, the legal profession, the architects, all the other agencies that we need to have garnered with us. We need to take them with us. We need to explain to the people that we have not changed, but we have done now called a housing revolution. Lal Bahadur Shastri was the shortest minister, prime minister in India. He had to face the Chinese war and had to face a drought situation where he went with a begging bowl to Canada and US to ask for grains for India. In the next 48 months, he made a change called the Green Revolution. Illiterate farmers of India who had no communication of TV or communication of other wherewithal made a paradigm that since then till today, 45 years, we have never had such a drought which has caused us to beg for food. Today we have IPOs, we have ECBs, we have people going on stock exchange, we have FDI, we have township policies, we have wonderful developers like this in India. And all over India we have corporates coming in, Tatas are coming in, Mahindras are coming in, Godrejis are coming in. Why is it that we cannot commit to say that this housing for all will be done? When in those days of Lal Bahadur Shastri, in 2 years, illiterate farmers, poor people and farmlands made that housing revolution happen. Can we not in Naredko commit a housing revolution that will happen? And we shall do it, and it shall be starting not tomorrow, but starting visioning that from today. That is what I think we need to aspire, not for other people, but for ourselves. When we go to the God above, we should say, we are the builders of India. We built this India. We built it not only for the rich, but also for the poor. And I promise you, once we decide that we need to do it, there are teams of people, young and old, who would love to dedicate their lives to get this objective done. And I am certain that the entire media, the entire people of this great city, this great country, will follow the leadership of Naredko, not only in the western region, but I'm sure after that we will have the entire Naredko all over India take leadership which will be second to none. This is what I wanted to tell Sunil, that yes, I will take up this responsibility, but that is not enough. We need to do much more, and I am much older than him, so I need to do it faster than what he thinks we should do. Thank you very, very much.